To add or subtract rational expressions, we must have the same or like denominators. Notice these two examples do not contain like denominators. So for the first step, we're going to rewrite the problem, leaving a lot more space horizontally and including parentheses around the denominators. So we'll have 3 over the quantity x minus 3 plus 2 over the quantity x plus 5. Well, to have like denominators, or the same denominators, both denominators must contain the same factors. Notice how this denominator has a factor of x plus 5, but this one doesn't. So we can multiply this denominator by a factor of x plus 5, as long as we do the same to the numerator. Remember, anything over itself is equal to 1, so this is like multiplying by 1. Notice this denominator does not have the factor of x minus 3, so again we can multiply this by x minus 3, as long as you do the same to the numerator. And now notice the denominators contain the same factors, and therefore we have the same denominators. So now we can add these fractions by keeping the denominator the same and adding the numerators. So our denominator is going to be the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity x plus 5. Remember, the order of this doesn't matter because it's multiplication. And now we're going to combine the numerators, so we'll have 3 times the quantity x plus 5 plus 2 times the quantity x minus 3. So now we'll distribute in the numerator and combine like terms. So here we'll have 3x plus 15. Here we'll have 2x minus 6. And now we'll combine like terms in the numerator. We have 3x plus 2x, that's 5x. And then we have 15 minus 6, that's equal to 9. And since 5x plus 9 does not factor, this does not simplify. So we can leave our answer like this, or sometimes you'll see it where we have parentheses in the numerator as well. Either form is acceptable. Now let's take a look at an example of a subtraction problem. Again, for the first step, we're going to leave some room horizontally and put parentheses around the denominators. So we'll have 7 over the quantity x plus 2 minus 5 over the quantity x plus 3. And now we want to have denominators with the same factors. So this denominator needs a factor of x plus 3. So we'll multiply this fraction by x plus 3 over x plus 3. And this denominator needs a factor of x plus 2. So we'll multiply by x plus 2 over x plus 2. And now that we have the same denominator, the denominator is going to stay the same. Quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x plus 3. And now we'll combine the numerators by subtracting. So we'll have 7 times the quantity x plus 3 minus 5 times the quantity x plus 2. Now we'll clear the parentheses and combine the like terms in the numerator. So here we'll distribute 7. So we'll have 7x plus 21. And here, because of the subtraction, we'll think of distributing a negative 5. So we'll have negative 5x or minus 5x, and then negative 10 or minus 10. So again, we'll have 7x plus 21 minus 5x minus 10. And now we'll combine the like terms in the numerator. 7x minus 5x would be 2x. And 21 minus 10 is equal to 11, so we have plus 11. Again, the numerator does not factor, and therefore this does not simplify. And again, sometimes you will see the numerator in parentheses as well. Again, either form is acceptable. Okay, I hope you found these two examples helpful. We'll take a look at two more in the next video.